Yeah, anything else we need to determine before we start
No, I think
here?
we're actually rarely organized. I got your sheet here.
I'm sure that will change.
One, two, three, everybody get set. Four, five, six, are we having any fun yet? Here comes Jimmy with the rubber boots pod, presented by bedsafe.net. It's 100% free. 100% free. No gimmicks, no strings, it's free. We'll talk about life and a little sport. Now you know we're gonna play some games. But if nothing else, you know you're gonna have a laugh. You're gonna have a laugh. We're gonna have a laugh. This is the podcast. This is the podcast. This is the pod.
If you guys don't mind, let's embark on a little role playing to spice things up. Again?
I thought you'd never ask.
So it's March break. It's what should have been March break in Ontario.
Oh, it is? Oh, nice.
Yes.
Yeah.
I should be in Turks and Caicos right now.
Yes.
This is a first world problem. I'm not complaining. I'm allowed to be sad. I'm allowed to be a little sad. I realize it's not important compared to the rest of the world. Yeah. But let's pretend that I'm there. So what would we be doing in Turks and Caicos? Take me back there.
Welcome to Island Time, Turks and Caicos' hottest new podcast.
Puffy would be drunk.
Yeah.
Lester would be strumming his guitar by the pool. Or Lester actually was in his room most of the time.
Also strumming.
Yes.
Stoff.
No, man,
Nicole.
Listen, hold on.
Yeah, you had a medical kit. You had a medical kit.
Yeah, sure.
But I would also say I was pretty fatigued at the time too. But I think about this time we would have been just finishing up our lunch, which would have been brought to us by, what was her name?
Brooksy.
Ping.
Not Brooksy.
Ping. Ping.
Ping.
Ping.
Ping. Oh, man, those hamburgers, I still think about them.
Oh, those hamburgers were good.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So good. James's wife would be dropping over in a couple hours to drink our wine.
Yeah. Double bottling it.
All of it.
So one of my rich golf buddies has a place down in Turks.
Yeah.
I think you've met him, Puffy Troy.
Yep.
And he now plays with Ames at the,
really?
At the course. Yeah.
Oh.
So it's going to be a little bit of a letdown for him when he gets back and he's playing with me at King's Riding after playing regularly with Ames every week.
Now, will you get the invite with Ames when you return to Turks?
It's a good question. I don't know if I want to bring my game out to his. He's too damn good. Here's the thing. The thing I love about Ames is that, you know, he's a friggin' tour player. He's still on the Champions Tour.
Yeah.
And when he's not on the Champions Tour, he just goes, there's no range at that golf course.
Oh,
he just goes out and plays with his buddies and then goes off and does a Champions Tour event. He doesn't grind
every
for
day?
3 hours anywhere.
He plays every day?
They just play every day down there, a bunch of guys, a bunch of Turks guys.
Awesome.
Anyway, yeah. You know, maybe our next trip will be, maybe Mattia from BetSafe.net. Welcome to the Rubber Boots Podcast.
Yes.
BetSafe.net. Maybe Matcha. I keep asking him and then I forget how to say it. Matcha. Matcha. M-A-T-T-I-A. Matcha. Right?
Matcha.
That's how they say
it
in Malta.
Sounds good.
Matcha.
Yeah.
I think I said it right the first time. Anyway, he's listening. Email me and correct me if it's wrong. Maybe he has a villa on the coast of Malta.
We do like villas.
Wow. Yes.
And
we are a villa podcast.
Yeah, Matthew, if you didn't listen last year, we're now doing the podcast for an audience of one, our sponsor. one of our previous sponsors was just a place called the Waimara in Turks and Caicos. So we went on a trip to Turks and Caicos. So we were thinking the BetSafe.net could take us to Malta. And
perfect.
Does Malta have, you want to Google Malta beaches?
Greetings from the local councils of Malta. We make up 68 municipalities. We will show you.
Malta, oh, no. Like Malta has beaches. Spectacular beaches.
Incredible beaches.
Right? Mind, look up best place to vacation in Malta or best beach in Malta. Let's see what we can come up
fast.
With. It's, because I think the BetSafe guys will give us exactly what we want.
Should,
we don't
I
just want to say
this.
A villa in Malta. We'll say a villa on the
where to stay in Malta for 20
Gozo?
For 20. Gozo, yes, I've heard of that.
Gozo is big.
Yeah, that's the first thing that came up here.
There's something called Bugiba and St. Paul's Bay.
Okay. I think Gozo is where we want to go.
Okay.
As the name would suggest.
Golden Beach Bay.
Oh, that sounds amazing.
Sounds pretty good.
Look at that.
Have our, I'm already on the Airbnbs here.
Is there a Golden Bar Bay?
I love gold.
That'd be spectacular. And you know what? We should get one of those. They should get us one of those boats that are like, you know, got the wood on the side that look like they were carved out of wood.
He said he carved it himself from a bigger spoon.
You know, like from like the talented Mr. Ripley. You know, those kind of boats.
I know what you're talking about.
Like where he killed.
We don't have to do that.
Spoiler.
Jude Law. That was an underrated movie.
You can't have a spoiler alert 20 years after the movie is out.
Wow, well, we got some young listeners.
That's true.
The Talented Mr. Ripley was a very good movie.
Creepy.
Incredibly creepy, but he sort of brilliantly gets away with most of his creepiness throughout, right? And you almost find yourself cheering for him. Kind of
most. Almost. No, that's fair.
Maybe not. A little show and tell, new segment.
Oh, show and tell, just the game I play when I want to say I love you.
Show and tell. It might only last 1 week, but I had a couple of show and tell items for you guys.
Oh, perfect.
Our friends at Cabot, they sent me a Christmas gift, but it went to the wrong address. Wrong address. So Andrew got me back, and I got a Cabot putter cover.
Oh, very nice.
Wow.
Very nice.
So when Puffy goes for his fitting later this week, add that to the TaylorMade putting cover.
Just slide that on there.
We'll be reporting next week on the podcast about Puffy's fitting. It's a big TaylorMade fitting.
Very exciting.
Got the brand new Cabot Cape Breton.
I like it. CCB, I like that.
Awesome.
I like that. Looks Cabot pretty cool.
On the side.
Yeah.
And then just this limited edition Dream Golf. Look at that's the 16th green, Puff.
That is spectacular.
Yeah. That's where you got to go. You got to make the trip sometime. Also on Show and Tell today, this was we said goodbye to our friend Chris Schultz on the weekend. We talked about Schulte last week, so I won't go too long here, but this is what we got at the funeral. A couple cool things. A Schulte card from the Argos. I haven't even opened this up yet because I kind of want to keep it together, but I'll take it out for you. There's a Schulte card.
Super cool.
And just some really neat little Schulte quotes. And this was the best part. So if I didn't talk about it last week, Schulte was famous for his organization, his highlighters, and his Sharpies. Mm-hmm. Schulte wrote out every single word he ever said on TV. Now, I shouldn't say that because he had to ad-lib sometimes, but when he had a chance to prepare, he would write out every single word in Sharpie and use highlighters to underline it. And so Monica, his sister, actually gave us Sharpies from Schulte's desk. They were still on his desk. So these came directly from Schulte's desk, and I will cherish them because that's one of the things I will remember most about him. Funerals are not fun events, but as far as funerals go, this was an incredibly therapeutic event, at least for me. And I think for the people at TSN, Rod Smith did an unbelievable job as MC. I was fortunate enough to speak. Mike Hogan spoke. Pinball Clemens spoke. Monica, Schulte's sister, spoke unbelievably well. And the neat thing for me was that Schulte was very guarded about the other side of his life. He never really talked much about it. And so Monica got to talk, and Schulte's brother Mark was there too, about what Schulte was like as a kid and everything, which was very cool. In fact, she had a teddy bear. When Schulte was little, they played like football with a team of teddy bears against her dolls. And they still had this old teddy bear that Schulte used to use when he was 5 years old. And it was just the weirdest contrast with one of the toughest, biggest guys I've ever known. And this little teddy bear sitting at the front of the church. But then we tailgated after the funeral.
Oh, nice.
At safe distance in the parking lot, Jock Climie went and bought some beverages, and that was my favorite part, because all sorts of other Schultzy stories came out, and that's always the best way to remember a guy afterwards. It's just a bunch of guys sitting around talking, and it was Climby and myself and Rod Black and Rod Smith and Paul Lapolice, coach of the Ottawa Red Blacks, who worked for TSN, and just on and on. And it was just a really, really good time. Jamie Rattle Bump, of course.
Nice. It's so important. It's so important to have those conversations. And look, obviously, we're in a situation where it's still a pandemic, so you were able to do that at a safe distance and properly salute our friend and colleague. So it's great, man. I'm glad you guys got to do that. And it's unfortunately, with this pandemic, you know, in my personal life, I've had a number of people, friends of the family, pass away and stuff like that, and you can't do much, right? So I anticipate there's going to be a flood of memorials and celebrations as well. There's going to be one for Darch, I know. So, you know, we'll just have to wait. But it's so important. It's a very, very important part of the grieving process. So glad you were able to do that.
Thank you, buddy. It was. I didn't. By the way, I'm not even sure how we were allowed to have it. I guess where it was in Burlington is in whatever color stage.
Probably
where
in a red zone. Yeah,
they were only in a red zone. Yeah, there were only 50 people allowed at the funeral, and everybody was spread out like two people per pew, basically. Okay. So you were six people apart. Yeah, so that was the first. That's the first group event I've attended in a year, basically. Wow. Yeah. But just really good to see everyone who was there. A lot of people I hadn't seen for a year, and it was good. Okay, some important updates. Had my eye consultation with my eye surgeon.
Oh,
so
which one? Are you so taking
which one?
I walk into the Eye Institute. I don't, you know what? I'm not going to give the company name unless they give me free eye surgery. So, so there's a bunch of photos on the walls, some recognizable people.
Ooh.
One of the people on there was Seamus O'Regan, former host of Canada AM, yes, who I believe is now an MP or was an MP.
Yeah, he's in politics for sure. I'm not sure what his status is now, but yes.
So, you know, benefits of Canadian pseudo-celebrity. I see him up there and I'm like, yeah. I texted him and said, Seamus, how did your eye...
Hold on a second.
How did your eye thing turn out?
How did you have his number? Is there like just
TV
is
people.
It just like TV people and the you just all you like national types you just
yeah we all numbers we all text each other once in a while
once you reach a certain tier
yeah
we all communicate. It's like the Stonecutters episode of The Simpsons, like there's those special highways under the city for us.
So long, suckers.
So I'm like, hey, Seamus, I don't think I've ever texted you before, but actually, I DM'd him.
Did you? Okay.
I DM'd him. Seamus, I've never actually DM'd you before, but I'm sitting in this eye institute and your signed autograph pictures on the wall. How are your eyes doing? Like, oh, they're great. Got right back to me. But there's another guy. There's only two people in the waiting room. And the other guy's got all his the medical stuff on. He's going to have the surgery today. He's got the gown and the little hat on. So Jimmy, if you remember, was either going to have the mono surgery, the dual lens replacement, the pirate, or the double pirate.
Double pirate.
And we voted on the pirate.
My beloved fans all voted on the double pirate. So I was thinking about having the double lens. A little riskier, but that's where I was going. So I'm like, this guy's like, so what are you in for? Like we're in prison or something. And I go, yeah, I'm just having my consultation today. What looks like you're having surgery. He goes, yeah. I said, what's it for? What are you having? He goes, well, I had the lens replacement last year and didn't work out. Just cloudy the whole time. I'm like, what do you mean by cloudy? He's like, imagine being up in the clouds. That's what my eyes been looking like.
They're not putting that guy up on the wall.
He goes, but they're fixing me today.
He's getting taken down.
He goes, they're fixing it today. I'm getting a new lens. It was just, I got a piece of metal in my eye back 20 years ago, and they think that screwed it up or something. Okay, yeah, so, I mean, he's back. He's back in the same place, so he must still trust the place.
What else are you going to do?
Yeah, no. Yeah. Once that happens, no other doctor will touch you.
Yeah, exactly. I was a little bit was a little bit rattled. That's I think, why I DM'd Seamus. So I go into the doctor and I'm like, Doc, I was just talking to some guy in the waiting room and things did not go well for him. And he's like, oh, yeah, Phil, that was not a good case.
It was a flincher.
Don't worry, we'll take care of him.
Yeah. No, so he says, actually, I want you to have the monitor. I want you to, I think if your right eye is good enough to read with, because it's, remember, it's my distance vision, then I'm going to fix your left eye for distance and you're going to be fine. So that's what it looks like Jimmy's having. But they're going to try to put a couple of contact lenses in my eye that make me see better long to see if it works. Because as I told you guys the first time, I'm not sure. I don't really understand the brain about one eye for reading and one eye for, but apparently it works. So
will they put on like contact lens that doesn't come out?
No, I'll just have to try it for a couple of days, you know, take it in, take it out.
Ooh, that's not going to go well, Jimmy.
Oh, I'm not good at it. Remember, I left one in for like 6 days once.
Yeah, this ain't going well.
Oh, but I have my ophthalmologist. I always get the
Optometrist.
What's ophthalmologist then?
That's your bum.
Yeah.
That is not my bum. That's an anal metologist.
I don't think that's
an
true.
Analyst.
It's a proctologist.
Well, that's what it is. It's a proctologist, is your bum.
Maybe an ophthalmologist is the surgeon and an optometrist just looks at your eyes.
It might be the one who's like finds old bones like Indiana Jones.
Are we venturing into
that's an archaeologist
territory?
Oh, that's true.
Ophthalmologist. Surgery is going to say optometrist just looks at your eyes. That's my prediction.
Healthcare,
I'm all in. Four gold bars.
Four gold bars, back surgeon.
I love gold!
An ophthalmologist is not a back surgeon.
I actually don't know.
An ophthalmologist treats all eye diseases, performs eye surgery, and prescribes fits eyeglasses. So they do it all, I guess. Ding.
Well, then what the heck is the thing that we thought it was? The ophthalmologist.
The
optometrist just doesn't do all that stuff. That's the next... Optometrist, like 2 years of college. Ophthalmologist, 8 years of medical school. That's what I'm guessing.
Well, you know,
sorry, I don't mean to offend all the optometrists.
That's not the case.
Is an optometrist a doctor? They are not a medical doctor. No.
Oh,
no, they're not. They get a doctor.
They get a doctor of optometry degree after 4 years of optometry school.
Oh, interesting. So
you're a little off there, Jimmy.
So you can call yourself a doctor because I call Rita is my
I call myself a doctor all the time.
Not a doctor.
Oddly enough, Brooksy's dream was for one of her kids to become an ophthalmologist. She kept trying to push them all that way. I'm like, really? No, ophthalmologists are great, but Brooksy, let's push him to be like a heart surgeon or something like that. She's like, no, I just want an eye doctor.
Wouldn't brain surgeon be the ultimate? I would think so.
Yeah, but if my kids have any of my genes, they'll be messing people up.
Yeah, that's no good.
Yeah,
well, you'll assuming come out, they were all flag football players, they'd be great.
You'll come out goofy.
Yeah.
Thank you,
Stoff. So anyway, Rita, Rita, my optometrist, lives three houses down.
Okay.
And so I'll just go over her house and just stick one in my eye.
See, I'm lucky I've never had any sight problems because I don't think I could do the contacts.
I can't
put things in my own eye. Even eye drops are tough.
You know what? I'll tell you right now. I had a Halloween costume once where I had red contacts for the devil I was playing, and I used them the one time. I can never do it again. I've got them still. Mm. They're cool, but I just applying them. Yeah, I
putting something in your eye.
No. Crazy. I'm with you, Stoff. Yeah.
Well, Sorry, go ahead.
I was just gonna say my eyes have started to go now, and I'm gonna have to get reading glasses. And I don't know how much longer after that I'll have to get regular glasses because there's no chance I'm doing contacts.
But you'll look distinguished, Puff. It'll be a good look for you.
I think I will look smarter. Yeah. I will look smarter.
All depends on the frame.
I mean, it won't take much to make you look smarter. That's
unfair.
You should go with the one
uncalled for.
Why don't you go with the
Monocle.
Oh man.
Yes.
I should actually. That would be pretty
good. I should do that. The monocle on TV.
Yeah. does the monocle come with the old timey voice?
Well, it has to have the old timey accenty voice.
Because there's no one that is rocking a monocle now, right? Like,
could be a thing. No, I bet just some rapper, rapper
Monopoly guy.
Into a video.
Monopoly guy. He'd be your competition.
He's had a Monopoly on it for quite some time.
So I'm going after him.
Actually, that is like a billion-dollar idea. Somebody come out with like the monocle.
Yeah.
And like this hip hop guy or something. You're absolutely rapper, right.
Yeah, for sure.
It's silly.
But the monocle wasn't even attached, right? It just sort of sat. How did
work? You put it in there and you just kind of squint somehow. Gotta,
I think it's like a chain and then you just hold it up and you go, hello.
Yeah. And I think you can keep it there by squinting, right. But it is attached to something.
Yeah. I think it's just like kind of hanging.
Brought to you by BetSafe.net. We've got a lovely show today. The Gold Bar League is going to be absolutely fantastic.
I know that if you have a monocle, you also have to have a pocket watch.
It's a set.
It's 2:30. Let's go down by the lake.
They sell them the sets now.
We're rowing, children.
Mumsy, what are we having for supper?
So, monocle. We should have put that on the poll. Yeah. Maybe people would have voted for that. I'll inquire about the monocle. And even if I don't get the monocle, maybe I'll, as a full-time thing, I'll get the monocle just for the pod. I'll ask Dr. Rita if she could give me a monocle, a stylish monocle, and maybe I'll be the guy who brings monocles back.
I like it.
It seems to be a thing. You can get it here many places.
So, while we're on medicine, quickly, every year I do my, I have my medical down at MedCan. I'm the only idiot, not the only idiot, but who pays like $1,000 for a medical every year, because MedCan is this place where businesses pay their executives to get, you know, some, they don't want their CEOs to have heart attacks or whatever. So it's a place where you get a really thorough medical exam. It's not smart, like just a finger up the butt and cough and you're out of there.
The doctor's looking at the floor. I was looking at the wall, reading the certificates. That's when I realized there were no certificates on the wall.
It's like you have a whole bunch of things, stations. It takes like 5 hours. So I had my medical yesterday down at MedCan. It's a very good place, by the way. I was kind of making fun of the price, but it's worth it because they test your blood every year, and then you have, and they do like, remember I told you guys last year about being on the treadmill and trying to impress the girl with the rock music
and stuff.
Right. So it gives you a measurement every year to how you are as compared to last year, which I like. Mm-hmm. I want to know if my, you know, something's down and something's up and my white blood cells and my whatever and my, all that stuff. Couldn't do the treadmill this year because of COVID. Too many things attached to you in a too small room, too much sweat flying off your body.
Yeah, good break for you, Jimmy.
Yeah. The thing I wanted to mention, though, is that I have these little jokes I always tell because I'm like that guy, like the jerk guy who just tells the stupid jokes to see if they can make the people laugh. And I have standard jokes that I use every year because usually I get different people. Mm-hmm. So the poor lady who's giving me the ultrasound, whenever they give me the ultrasound, I say really seriously, please tell me it's a girl, right? Like I'm pregnant. She didn't laugh. So I was 0-for-1.
She then on the eye exam, before.
The eye exam, they put the thing over your eye. And then I go, iceberg, did it!
You're 2-for-2 with me, buddy.
Wow. Then I had the vaccine lady. I got my flu shot. So I'm in the vaccine lady.
I thought you almost dropped the line there, Jimmy.
No.
You fancy clinic.
Well, that was my line. I'm like,
you better not.
She was telling me the shingles vaccine. Yeah. I'm like, hey, seriously, if I slide you 20, little Pfizer for 20. And I said it just like that. Hey, little Pfizer for 20. She didn't, like, not only did she not laugh, she was like, we don't have those.
At what point did security come in?
And isn't Pfizer still do, like, aren't they still more well known for the boner pills?
I wouldn't know.
Maybe Pfizer's that's what she thought.
Pfizer was the Viagra.
I think they were their original boner pills.
Yeah, they were the Viagra.
Viagra, yes, I believe they are.
What if they mistakenly put some of that in the vaccine? And we all got, the nation opened up, but everybody was walking around with erections.
Well, they put it in your arm, so
including
you be walking around like
the women.
Women, lady erections.
Sorry, what? What did you say last year?
I said, if they put it in your arm and you're walking around like this, anybody would know.
It'd be more like this, which would not go well.
No, yeah. No, we're not.
So many more
problems. I swear it's the medicine.
What about...
I mean, everyone would be outside and excited.
Yeah.
Yeah, hell of a time to be alive.
Let's face it. We're all going to have the erections anyway this summer if we get to sit on a patio and go see people.
Right? God willing.
Yeah.
make sure I don't go to a patio with you. You're sitting there. No track pants for you, James.
What a boner.
I have a feeling you'd be asked to leave pretty quickly.
Yeah. Can I get a couple of Mick Ultras to go?
My vaccine is kicking in.
Hey, Jimmy, I know you're going to ask me how my week was.
I'm not done mine yet.
He's only on Wednesday.
Let me finish.
Oh, sorry.
So then I got to the fitness challenge.
Yeah.
And she asked me to take off my shirt, obviously. I don't think she asked everybody that.
Yeah.
And she said, you have a lot of freckles. And I said, yeah, my mom had an affair with a speckled trout. She actually laughed.
Seriously, you're killing. How is she not?
That was my one laugh. Jokes?
I got my one laugh.
Oh, she gave you a laugh. That's good.
So, but the point was braggadocious. So you do, in the fitness challenge, you have to do these push-ups, no hands. So you do a push-up, and then you let yourself go to the ground, lift your hands, and then you do another push-up. And last year I did 20. Mm-hmm. This year, at 30, she said, just stop.
Right? Wow.
Just stop. So all my 21-day flex clearly working. Then you have to do this thing where you just reach your arm over, and you try to see how close you can get.
Yeah.
264. Yeah.
With each side. Love's going an inch closer than last year. I'm more flexible.
Oh, wow.
Then you got to do something, some side bend, where there's a side bend machine. You got to hold yourself up. Right? She said average is 60 seconds, good is 70 seconds. Last year you did 80 seconds. At 95, she said just stop.
Wow.
Wow. Breaking machines.
Like, I'm getting older and getting
better.
Like, it's all happening for me right now.
So you're physically improving, but you're less funny.
Yeah. That's a good point.
You would take that trait, Jimmy. You would take that trait.
Yeah, of course.
I would. I'll take that. I might go in the, what's the show with the, like it's on TV where they're climbing the walls and jumping over stuff.
Gladiator?
American Ninja.
Yeah, I might go on America. I'm pretty much ready for American Ninja.
I said Wipeout. I thought Jimmy was more suited for that one.
Hey, Lester, how was your week?
Oh, my week was great, thank you. Yeah. I actually just wanted to make sure I mentioned something because and this is something that I didn't know. Forgive me my ignorance, and I guess it makes sense. But I was talking to a friend of mine, and she mentioned she had a dog at one point, but she had to get rid of the dog because the dog had a messy period at one point. And it was all over the house.
What is?
Oh, you meant? Oh, I thought you were meant menstruation. I'm like,
that's exactly what I'm saying to you. Exactly. And I'm like,
dog.
What?
Dogs don't menstruate.
That's what I thought.
I don't. What she think told me.
Oh, this is. Hold on a second.
Go to the Google machine.
I'm not googling. I'm not googling that. I fear what's going to come up.
In my one female dog.
I don't really need to see it.
Maybe when they fix them, they no longer do. Maybe when a female dog matures. Wow, this is a mind.
I don't know.
Do dogs menstruate? It's a pretty simple Google search. Anyone?
Yeah, they can.
Maybe Lester, your friend's dog got knifed.
Hang on, but so you're saying?
I mean, if they're killing Mondays in my backyard.
Yeah, they definitely can. Thanks for letting me know that information.
Well, look, female dogs can menstruate. I've never heard of it either.
Yeah they can.
Never heard of it either.
Do all female animals menstruate? This is reminiscent of the pigeon cocoa.
Well, do all female mammals? I guess.
Mammals, yeah.
Female mammals menstruate.
But I didn't know because you'd never mentioned it before. We talked about your dog's many times, right?
I mean, most female mammals have an estrous cycle, yet only 10 primate species, 4 bat species, the elephant shrew, and one known as the spiny mouse have a menstrual cycle. So I guess dogs wouldn't be included in that, but they have an estrous cycle.
I've never heard of a menstruating dog before. Thing. My dog just did fart, though.
What I was saying is she said like every 6 months or something like that would happen. I'm like, what? I never heard of it. No. I should find out what kind of dog.
You know what? Maybe it wasn't a dog. Maybe it was a, what was that animal you just mentioned? A little rat?
Yeah.
You know those urban myths about people bringing home a pig and bringing home a dog from Mexico and they find out it's a rat? Maybe that was, she had a spiny, what was it, a spiny mouse?
Spiny dog.
Yeah, spiny mouse.
Oh, my spiny
mouse. She thinks she's got a little chihuahua. She's got a spiny mouse dog.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Menstruating all over the house.
Well, look, it says right here, do dogs have periods? If you're thinking of adopting a female dog, you may wonder if a female dogs have periods. Or if you live with one that isn't spayed, you might be curious as to why she is bleeding. Female dogs do undergo a regular cycle and bleed once they reach maturity, if they are not spayed. So... that's what it is. Get
that's Bob Barker was right.
Well,
hey, betsafe.net, when you sponsored us, did you have any idea of the information and the quality education
betsafe.net
that you would be aiding in us giving Boots Nation?
You know, I mean, I don't mean hijack the segment, but the more you know, right?
Oh, wow. He did that.
Wow, that's fascinating. We've learned a lot today. This one, this might be our most educational. We got optometrist,
ophthalmologist.
We got dogs menstruating, spiny rat, spiny.
I just looked this up. Birds do not menstruate through their clothes.
Oh, that's not cool.
How many people are still listening?
This is a turnoff. I stopped listening.
For sure, the four of us.
Maybe.
I thought it was interesting. You know, it's bad when you're 45 minutes in and you haven't got to anything that's not prepared for the actual podcast.
No, this is far better.
Yeah.
So we'll whiz through this stuff. So first of all, I was supposed to promote off the top the March Madness bracket. Hey, guys.
You did well.
Look at this. I filled it all out.
I did too.
Now, it is true that I may have had to ask Stoff where exactly to go for the bracket. And he said, go to our social media accounts where I told people how to get to it. That was pretty dumb. Let's just say the Clemson Tigers are making a run in Jimmy's bracket. I don't want to give it all away because I don't want people to copy me. But the seventh seed in the Midwest is making a run.
If that happens, Jimmy, you will win the pool.
I think I got him out in the Elite Eight or something like that. Oh, God. This is where my... it's usually where my AirPods still working. I computers, I got phones, I got all sorts of stuff here. Can you guys still hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
I apologize to our viewers about my bad quality audio. Last week, my AirPods weren't working for half the show. So you can go, Stoff tweeted it out on the Rubber Boots Pod account.
It's our pinned tweet on our Twitter account. You can also go to YouTube, the link's there.
It's a Yahoo thing. You go on to Yahoo, you fill out the thing, it's real easy.
The deadline is this Friday at noon. So if you're listening to this Thursday night, you still got a couple hours to get your picks in. So the winner's going to get 50 free gold bars. I think we're going to decide on giving 20 to the second place.
Second place, 20 to the third.
Yeah. And I guess
that goes for us too. So that it's only a
four. No.
So
we got
our listeners. Our foursome gets 50.
No.
100%.
No. We got to beat the listeners if we want
to. Yeah, I know.
We got to beat them.
We're taking on the listeners. Someone in our league for the first time in the season has 50 gold bars, the leader has this week.
Wow. But that's seeing that we've already lent, three of the four of us have already been lent 5 gold bars, and I can set the rules, I'm going to lend us each 50 gold bars just for the March Madness. So we're going to be tied with the winner if we don't beat them.
Where are you getting 200 bars from?
I don't know. It's like the American government. They just stimulus money. Everybody just prints. Everybody's getting 10 gold bars stimulus. Make less than 80 grand a year. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Twitter, please. And apparently review us and give us 5-star reviews.
Yes.
Because
subscribe.
That's apparently important.
Retweet.
Subscribe to YouTube.
So this week, the College of Sports Media, which is a place where you can learn to be a sportscaster in Toronto, they asked to have me on as a special guest in their Zoom class. Nice. The teacher of the class was Paul Romanuk, a long time play-by-play, now teaching. So I didn't realize until, because I never read emails properly, as you guys know, only 2 minutes before I went on did I realize that the subject of this class was podcasting. So they decided to have a podcasting expert on, and the expert they chose was me.
Legend in the field.
So I get on there, and they're like, the questions start, and they're very smart kids.
Yeah.
So how do you, you know, how do you approach the marketing of your podcast and, you know, and your presentations to sponsors? And I'm like, yeah, well, like, we've never actually tried to get a sponsor. It's just if they write us, we sign them up.
We reach out to Malta.
Yeah. We've never really marketed until, you know, Stoff this year started doing. What about social media? Yeah, we sucked at that until this year. But I don't really know much about it. So then I had to stop and say, look, guys, I'm the wrong guy for marketing a podcast.
Aaron Dreger.
This is just me and my three buddies, right? We don't even know how to market. We just do the podcast. And if people want to listen and watch, they do. And if not, well, it's okay. We don't get mad. So yeah, Darren Dreger, like, he sends out 100 tweets a day for the Ray and Dregs podcast. They're soliciting all the time. They're, you know, they're doing 27 commercials per podcast. Yeah. We're not like that. We have our bet safe friends. That's all we want.
That's all we need.
That's it. I mean, we're not going to turn you down if you call and you offer us gold bars, but, you know, we're bet safe people now, right?
Exactly.
So anyway, that was quite entertaining. And clearly, I believe one of the students was a faithful Rubber Boots listener, and the others were like, this Rubber Boots podcast. So what is it pertaining? What exactly? How do you decide what subjects you're going to talk about every week? And I go, Stoff sends an email, and then we I talk about my dogs. We talk about dogs menstruating.
What you should have done is assign homework for them to listen to our podcast.
Yeah. And then come back on next week.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
The dogs menstruating segment. Hella, did you guys have meetings before that to discuss how you were going to talk about it?
Yeah, we told Lester to bring it up naturally in conversation.
Yeah. Yeah. If you could just work it in, Lester, and then we'll all...
You know what happened to me? I found a...
Anyway.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. So, but it went well. I faked my way through it.
Perfect.
Kind of used the Beauties podcast. There's a lot of action going on right now. I don't know what's going on over there.
Oh, boy.
Look at that.
I've seen that look before.
Uh-oh.
Oh, what happened? Him.
Where'd he go? Yeah. There he is.
He's back.
Am I back? I can hear you.
You're back.
I hit Siri by mistake. I should have asked her something. Do dogs menstruate? Okay, so Larry, sir, we got to get on with this thing. They also were asking me, like, what, you know, apparently the ideal length of a podcast is 25 minutes, and you don't want to go over 45 minutes. And they say, how do you decide on that? And I'm like, yeah,
preach.
We just go along.
Preach.
Sorry, Stoff. We'll get moving. Mailbag. A lot of people commented about the Schulte stories. Thank you very much. Snakebites Pete. My take on the first minute show. None of y'all grew up on a farm. Buy me a sixer and I'll make that bunny disappear. Snakebites Pete. I buried the bunny.
Oh, you did? Oh,
okay.
You guys got to me. So I went back to the back of the yard and I buried the bunny. It got warm enough. So thankfully the ground was kind of frozen, but there was enough. But I'm telling you what, if my dogs dig that bunny out and they come running in the house with a bunny ear, it's on you. All of you.
So guys. James, if someone said they would give you $5 million if you could show a buried bunny, would you take that?
What do you mean?
Like if someone said, I'll give you $5 million right now, but you have to show me where this bunny's been buried.
So
I don't think the bunny's been buried.
Wow.
You're doubting
why the bunny?
I don't think there's any chance.
I'm not going to lie. I was going to say it's very smart for you to admit that on record, James.
Yeah.
I buried the bunny. If I got rid of the bunny, I would have told you guys I got rid of the bunny. Okay.
I believe you.
I buried the bunny in the garbage bag.
Yes.
In the garbage bag.
No, it's not on your property anymore.
But did you have a ceremony?
The bunny is Okay, you know I have a big backyard. It's right at the back by the willow tree. No, I'm not kidding. I wouldn't kid you. When you come over, okay. When you come over next, we're digging to dig up the bunny. If that's what you want, desecrate the poor bunny.
I'll give you $500 cash if you can dig up a bunny in there.
Oh my God.
You want me to bring it to work?
Do you know what this is going to lead to? James is going to be hunting rabbits for the next few
weeks. I don't know. I got to be honest with you guys. I don't know why you guys are doubting James. Yeah,
Why would I wouldn't tell you. I wouldn't be ashamed to tell you if I dumped the bunny in the garbage or whatever.
For me and Puffy, it's just last week you said you're going to throw it in the garbage. So to come back this week and say you didn't and did it by the bylaws provided by
you guys scared me because I thought I'd end up on the cover of the Toronto Sun
and now you won't for sure.
Bunny in garbage, right?
Now you won't
because the Aurora garbage man. If he didn't get my tip, then maybe he'd turn me in.
I can't believe the bunny was at the
side of the house. It was a very nice day, and plus I was feeling a little, you know, Schulte had passed away, and I was feeling a little just, you know, tribute to the dead and you guys and guilty. And the bunny was in the garbage bag next to the house. So I grabbed my little shovel, the same shovel that I used to pick up the poops. And I went to the back of the yard and I buried the bunny.
Did you guys tell stories about the bunny?
I said a little prayer. I mean, I'm not a religious person, but I said, bunny, I hope you had a good life. I'm sorry you died a horrendous death in my backyard. Yeah. Yeah. And I hope my dogs don't dig you up. And there now you have to understand that the back of my dogs, there's like an area back there where they just don't go. It's too far. Like it's too far. And so there, I don't think they'll dig up the bunny, but I'm going to show you guys the bunny next time.
But if we go to where the bunny is and it's missing, the dogs got it. Then they did get it.
Oh, the coyotes.
The coyotes. The coyotes. That's what happened. The coyotes took away. Nothing you can do about that.
Now the real question is, what are we going to do about the Whirlpool guy?
Do you think the Whirlpool guy killed the bunny?
The Whirlpool guy. I'm telling you.
Yeah.
How is this going to keep happening?
Yeah. I DM'd Whirlpool last week to complain about how freaking long it took to get back to me. And they responded to my DM.
Ooh.
Spicy. May we have your telephone number and the reason for your call? Thank you, Maddie. So I gave her my number, but she's not getting back to me. So say Whirlpool, you're still on notice.
Wow. Looks like you showed them.
I sure did. I got them with my angry DM. Because I'm not one of those guys that complains about companies on Twitter publicly. I always find it annoying when sportscasters complain about planes or whatever to Air Canada. I think it's cheesy. But I am the guy who DMs.
Oh, you do?
Hey. Do you have any idea who I am? I'm being nice to DM you right now. But I could ruin you. Like Whirlpool, I could ruin you. Yeah. One tweet.
One tweet, it's over.
What else from the mailbag? Leah McAvoy, award for Twitter excellence. To Adam, the emotional support Canadian, for his Seinfeld and his I Love Gold meme mashup.
I love gold, Jerry. Gold!
He did a very good job, didn't he,
Stop? Very good.
Excellent, yes. Love
that. Nathan Johnson, Puffy is 19 with that bucket. Probably applies to this week as well.
Last week, yeah. My hat, the brim was very, very big. Mm.
What does it mean, Sean Cameron? I'm all hat tonight. What does that mean?
Well, that was
you
just
responding?
Puffy's response to that message. Yeah. These are from the chat from the premiere night.
Yes. Yeah. You, were you there?
You weren't there.
Yeah, you skipped out again.
He was burying the bunny at that time.
Abe Froman, David Carson, and Snake Bites Pete let us know that Abe Froman was the sausage guy because I'm not particularly good at coming up with names live on the air. Let's do things that I saw on Twitter.
Freaky pigs, strange chicks, world affairs, polar bears, fake news, nice shoes, big boobs, jack dudes, all of these things and more as I sat on the shitter. Things that I saw on Twitter.
I'm going to start. I'll just go through. Okay. Good. I'm an editor. I'm a professional editor. That's what I do. That's my entire career is taking information in and deciding what's important to the people.
Love it.
I want to give you love for the Headless in Aurora movie trailer.
Fantastic. Thank you.
Dramatic day. My wife and Gracie sent me a photo of the backyard. You know, the photo 30 yards away, so it was kind of a little grainy. And there's a body in the backyard. Decapitated, no tracks.
Our suspects right now are Water Guy and Jared.
Serious Lester coming at you right here. Hey, we're gonna have a problem, big problem.
We open the back, in the back, dead buddy. Do you think the Whirlpool guy killed the buddy?
It's the Whirlpool guy, I'm telling you.
Some of your finest work. I actually want to see the film, and now there's going to be a whole plot twist of whether I buried the bunny or not. All sorts of things.
That's part two.
Yeah.
Ben Stiller is James Duffy.
Puffy. Everyone was making fun of some guy named James Duffy that they were interviewing on the CBC.
Oh, I saw.
Everyone's saying I didn't age very well. That was funny.
Yeah, that was good.
Monica Lewinsky made a funny tweet. She said, somebody said, if Twitter were around in the 90s, name a famous event moment that definitely would have had the TL in shambles. What's the TL?
Timeline.
Timeline.
Huh. <Caught him. laughs> And Monica wrote, not playing. Good on you, Monica.
She was playing.
Well, I'm not being as good as I thought I would be at getting through this information. So Bieber drops a love letter to the Leafs. We had a game that night, good. And we tried to get approval to use that to open our game. We could not get approval. So, I mean, why do you write a song, love letter to the Leafs, and then you won't let TSN use the love letter? I love the Biebs.
Well,
I'm not complaining to him.
Do you think
probably
that
his people.
Yeah, it did not reach people. Bieber. There's no chance never, it reached him. No.
If it's Bieber be a record heard company the words rubber issues. Boots.
Yeah.
He would have.
You wanted to, after the success of our shorting stock markets.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
We were going to explain Bitcoin, but you jump right past that into RBNN, Money Talk. Bitcoin, by the way, just to explain Bitcoin to people, you type something into your computer, and when your computer breaks, you rip it open, and there's some little stuff in there. You can mine a little piece of Bitcoin out of it, and then you're rich. It's worth like 60,000.
Make sure you get the megabytes.
Knowing that I destroy any stock that I buy,
yes,
my record is almost perfect for that. Should I buy Bitcoin in order to single-handedly destroy Bitcoin?
Yes.
Yeah. Like Elon Musk buys $1.5 billion, it goes up. I buy $1,000 and I could tank the thing down to $10,000, don't you think?
$1,000. So how much is it for one Bitcoin now? It's like
60,000 US or something like that.
It's ridiculous.
For one.
I don't know.
People aren't buying one Bitcoin though. They're buying, basically it's impossible. It's hard to buy Bitcoin now. If you were going to get into Bitcoin now, Puffy, you would be buying probably the Bitcoin. Like there's a stock you can buy in Bitcoin that you pay a premium for that basically goes up at the same price. So like Bitcoin Canadian is today at $68,000 Canadian for one share. So you're basically just paying a premium to buy a stock that basically echoes the value of Bitcoin.
Okay.
It's complicated to actually buy Bitcoin right now. Anyway, sorry, I'm getting sidetracked again. RBNN, do you want to explain the non-fungible token stuff to us?
Well, yeah, I just wanted to bring it up. NFTs, as they're known, they've been kind of dominating the headlines lately. And so more or less is what it is the ability to sell digital moments online. So it says here more or less that it's a unique and can't be replaced with something else. That's a non-fungible. That's what it means. And for example, Bitcoin is fungible, so it could be traded one for another. Here, these are things that can't be traded for one for another. So exactly like, I guess, memories or performances. So certain things that have sold have been like a music video by the artist Grimes. Someone paid over $390,000 for a 50-second video.
So does he own... Because I heard there's high, you can buy highlights now, like LeBron's highlights or whatever, right?
Right. And so this is the part I'm still trying to get to. I don't really understand what the ownership entails you to, because you can own something. You can even own like a meme, apparently, but other people are able to use this and use it online. You know, other people could, I guess, post your highlight that you own. So does the ownership come into, like, if you try to ever monetize something like this, or is it rather just the knowledge that you own this? Like, so, because it's, this is meant for digital art. So it's not, you know, it's not like, maybe comparison would be like you have the Mona Lisa.
Right.
That people could print their own and put hang it in their homes, but they would not have the original. I guess maybe that's somewhat of a good
Because tweets are one of the things that you can buy tweets.
Yes, yeah, somebody bought the first tweet.
Yeah, well, that's what it was. It was the first tweet ever, I believe.
No, but there's all sorts of tweets. There's some like app where you can buy tweets now, and I see these bids for like $28 for like a tweet.
Oh, we should be selling all our tweets.
Yeah, we should sell all our tweets.
Yeah.
Where's the beef?
I was actually thinking, should we be selling episodes of the podcasts?
I
think we should.
Let's do an auction for this episode. So you can submit submit your bids.
You can own all this dog menstruation talk.
This is going to be a classic.
Oh yeah,
this is a classic already.
No,
sorry, I brought it up.
No, I just drove the price to the ceiling. If that video by Grimes went 6.6 million, I think this episode is worth 240 grand.
Yeah, probably.
And I expect one of our Andrew Arsenault, Snake Bites, Pete, some of our loyal listeners, I expect you to ante up. Maybe you guys could put a little conglomerate together to buy it.
Wow.
Ho. Come on,
Ho. Get in there, Ho.
Ho. Just don't open it at 100 grand, Ho. Nothing could go wrong. I'm sure it'll bid up from there.
I think I'm going to have to bid on the one that I tell the story of my pants, because I don't want that getting out there into the wrong.
I should bid on Daddy Bath.
I was going to say, how much do you think Daddy Baths are worth?
Oh, yeah. Daddy Bath is worth a lot.
Imagine the money I'd be making on the themes.
No, those there actually you go. Aren't.
Well, let's sell Lester's songs.
That's true.
Only the three-way split. Get the proceeds.
All right, it's happened before.
Lester's an artist. He doesn't want to be sullied with money.
That's right.
No, sully me. I'm not proud.
Okay, so that was RBN and Money Talk. I think we figured it all out again. I think it's pretty clear to everyone.
Oh yeah,
and now you can go out and buy whatever you want.
Yeah, so
CFL and X. Sorry, go ahead. Stop.
I was just gonna say you can bid on our NFT episodes on any of our social media posts.
We could probably sell the whole thing for like $7.5 billion.
Like, yeah, I'd be willing to
even
cash
future
out the
episodes.
Throw it all together.
Yeah, future episodes included.
All our tweets, all our episodes, everything. All stuff, Instagram,
everything.
All right,
bundled. Yeah. Oh, one of Lester's guitars.
Yeah, we'll give two of those. Two of the guitars.
Lester's blow-up doll.
Yes.
Oh, I don't have a blow-up doll.
Trampoline.
And the rebounder.
Hey, the rebounder. Hold on.
I call this.
Signed.
Hugo, you got to get Hugo as well.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Hugo is priceless.
And the sheets that he...
NFT.
Hugo's got a price and it's $7.5 billion.
That's right. How about, remember when Stoff used to do the XFL picks? That was a huge, like, those episodes themselves would be worth a lot of money. Now the CFL possibly teaming up with the XFL. I'm not sure about this idea, by the way.
Not good
but
at all.
Stoff, that could be.
You don't think it's a good idea?
It's a terrible
Stoff could
idea.
End up as the insider. Like, he could replace Dave Naylor because he's the XFL guy.
Basically is the XFL guy.
Yeah.
Interesting.
It might be the only way to financially survive.
I'd rather the CFL would fold.
Than going with the XFL?
Okay, why? Why?
No.
Come on.
Because as soon as they go in business with the XFL, the CFL's done. It's over. It won't exist anymore.
The Rock
did not pay $15 million to own the CFL one day. Like, it will not be anything like the CFL currently is. except well, maybe look, the franchise.
Is that a terrible thing, though?
Yes.
Yeah, it is.
There's
a Toronto. There's a Toronto perception of this, and then there's the rest of the country perception of this. And like Toronto's like, oh, cool, the Rock's going to come in, the CFL will be cool again. But I think, you know, in Saskatchewan and Alberta, where the CFL matters, the three downs
even
matter.
Even in Hamilton, Ottawa,
absolutely.
Also, for you guys, it's if they got rid of the three downs.
Yes, three downs.
That's a big part of it. Yeah,
okay. I'm sure. I understand from a traditional standpoint for sure, but if you're comparing the two games, a four down game is much better.
I think it would also
it opens you up to an audience south of the border. It will obviously open you up to a much bigger audience in this country, because as much as those traditional areas, and they do support the NFL, the CFL. I think for the CFL to survive and be viable in any way, you do need to reach the bigger markets in this country.
Well, I just think I agree with what you're saying, Stoff. Like, I don't necessarily think you need to get rid of the three downs if you don't need to, but I do believe. I personally am very concerned about the CFL because not playing last year was a big hit. And look, this league, throughout the course of history, at some point has always been on the verge of folding. And I think if you have an opportunity with a high-profile person like The Rock and this new league, even if there's somehow they exchange players or one becomes – like they come together somehow in a way as far as players are concerned and developing and stuff like that, I think it's going to be important. To me, it's something that has to happen. And I do think if we want to see the league, the CFL in particular, flourish, you have to evolve to some point. Absolutely. And that's all I'm saying. Yeah. That's all I'm saying. I think that's the easiest way I can.
Those are all valid points. It may be right. Like if this may be the only way the CFL feels like it can survive if it's doing this. And I don't disagree with any of those things. The four down thing. Look, I love all football, but I think there's just to say the four down game's better. Three down games can be great. Four down games can be great.
There's pros and cons to both of them. I mean, awesome thing about the CFL has always been that if a team's even down by, you know, double digits late in the fourth, they can still technically come back because
that's probably the number one thing I love about the CFL. The games are not over.
100%. I find a lot of the times in the three down game throughout the course of an entire game,
too many punts.
It stalls. Yeah. It stalls way too
many
much,
punts. So, fair enough. Anyway, I don't know. I'm with Puffy. I wanted Halifax to have a team, and I like the idea of the All-Canadian League, and I know that maybe it was in trouble
They kept it as, you know, two separate conferences and only the champions?
I don't know. Yeah, it could work. Like, I think you guys might be right. Maybe
that'd
be awesome. Maybe this will be –
Maybe
I just think
maybe that would be – yeah, maybe that would work, but I don't
– Places like Saskatchewan, Winnipeg, Alberta, like you say, they're not going to accept this well if it's suddenly it's gone and it's just four downs and it's the XFL and we're playing the San Antonio – Titans or whatever 1 week. So
and listen, if that happens, I think you fold. I think the league just folds because it's not the CFL anymore, you know?
Right.
So I believe The Rock has enough respect for the league because he played in it that he won't do that. That won't happen, you know? So.
But you can't have two divisions and one place three downs and four downs and then have a championship.
No, I think that's the one thing that you would have to kind of come together on the road.
And maybe this is The Rock slow playing a revenge after being cut by the Calgary Stampeders.
Mm-hmm. Hold on. Here's another thought about this, though. Listen, you had the interleague play in baseball. In National League, you had the designated hitter the American League, you had the designated hitter. In the National League, you did. I mean,
but in the World Series, you always had to go one way or the other, right? Like it wasn't, or
one half, three downs.
I don't think so.
But that's just that's a batter, and it is a bit different. I'm just saying, you can't have a mix in football because exactly one team's going to have three downs on offense, and the other one have four.
Yeah.
No. If you play a game in Canada, it's three downs.
Sure, I guess I'm talking about if you split them up and had a one grand final, you do have to have the same rules in that one final. And
I just think the games are so different. The players, like the width of the
it's
field,
the strategy too
the
of
body
it.
Types yeah. of yeah, it, too hard to do. I'm almost sorry I brought this up because I was trying to get through this thing and now we're an hour and 45 minutes.
Oh, this is great. I love this. This is way better.
Let's get to Puffy's
flow, man.
Let's get back to the dogs on the street.
Puffy's props.
Brought to you by
BetSafe.net.
All right, quickly through Puffy's props. Apparently, I'm going to let. Okay, we're not going to have the big Clemson. We're not going to have the big Clemson sock. What was that? What did I miss?
Just Puffy's props. How he's saying the thing. It's not even Puffy's close. That's props. All good.
We're not going to have the big Clemson discussion. We're too heavy already. 2 cents. I think it just should have been the Clemson win. But Stoff and Puffy both pointed out that in soccer betting, if it goes past normal time, it is called a tie. No debate. Mm-hmm. Everyone wins on the Clemson bet. Only the people that had Clemson winning should have won, but everyone wins. Everyone's winning their bet.
Technically, it's the other way around, but we'll be nice.
I don't care.
Clemson won.
No.
In all fairness, Jimmy, I think you do owe our listeners an apology for that horrendous prop.
Okay, I didn't know the rules of soccer. I think everyone, all our listeners, would
Jimmy,
be happy with
this. You were an All-American.
Yeah. How did you not?
Okay, when I was there, during my time there, the games either ended in a win or a tie. We didn't have extra time.
I feel there was a lot of off-field issues.
I can remember one time Jimmy scored an added time, and we beat Maryland to win the ACC title, and there was no extra time in that game. Added time. So if there's a difference between added time and extra time, just so you know.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Thanks for clarifying that. Those poor Terrapins lost.
I love gold, and so do you. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Join the Gold Bar League, and you can have some too. Do-do-do-do. The gold bar league. Come on, enjoy the gold bar league.
Gold bar standings. How do I only have 11? I thought I did good this week. Leicester's in first with 17.
You broke even this 14. Week, I believe, Jimmy.
Yeah, well, that sucks. Chewy Louie, another big week, plus 12. This guy's a machine. Ho was really angry about he wanted my interpretation, right? Just the Clemson win.
He just wanted the Clemson win, yeah.
Arsenal also just wanted the Clemson win. He's in third. Brick Driveway, a bad week, dropping down to fourth. Ooh. Linden 77 screwing up again. Yeah. Tried to bet bars he did not have, but he did correct his mistake in time.
Yes, he did. I told him to smarten up.
Yeah. And David Carson suggested maybe you could have the props ready in advance.
Well, we tried.
We like a lot.
So we did. This week we have the props ready in advance. We're not going to waste any time. Here are our Puffy's props brought to you by BetSafe.net. You can go to the BetSafe and get all sorts of lines on the tournament and everything else going on. We decided to pick a tournament game. Don't forget to fill out your bracket. But within this, it's the game within the game. Oklahoma versus Missouri, Saturday, 7:25 p.m. Oklahoma is an 8 seed. Missouri is a 9 seed. It's a straight up bet. I'm going to start. Jimmy's going to, who did I take in my thing? I better take the same team. Or should I hedge? Should I hedge?
Hedge it.
Do it. But you still don't know which one it is.
I took Oklahoma. Oh, 8 seed. Boomer Missouri.
Oh, you're going.
So I gotta stick with that. I'm taking Oklahoma. Two gold bars on Oklahoma.
How many bars do I have?
Oh yeah, that's a good thing.
Second prop bet. You guys can get your picks ready. We wanted to put the Sabres in this week because they're awful. I mean, they are so awful. They're going to have to rebuild the rebuild of the rebuild of the rebuild of the rebuild.
Mm-hmm. Quick story.
So the Sabres. Yeah.
Sorry. I was going to say there was a little poll on on Instagram. They've got the Seattle Kraken who haven't played a game ahead of the Sabres.
No way. Funny. That's unbelievable.
Funny and true. Sabres play Boston on Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
If you pick the Sabres, you will get paid at 2-1. And if it goes to overtime or a shootout, you also win on the Sabres bet.
Sabres.
All right. So just to clarify, hold on.
That means that if you pick Boston and they win in a shootout or overtime, you lose.
You lose.
Yeah. Boston has to win in regulation for you to win the bet. And it's also 2-1. So we're giving you a lot of teasy on the Sabres. So you bet one gold bar on the Sabres. Either the game goes to overtime or shootout, or the Sabres win. You win two gold bars. Jimmy is going. It's in Buffalo?
Yes.
I believe so, yes. 1 o'clock start.
Three gold bars, Boston.
I love gold.
Last bet. We enjoyed our golf bet last week, the golf prop. Doug Gim is dead to me. One of the nicest guys on tour.
But love it.
I'll never trust him again. The one guy who put it in the water on 18 in the final three groups. This week we're at the Honda Classic. You might have noticed Justin Thomas winning the tournament. Justin's girlfriend or wife, I think girlfriend, maybe to be wife. Girlfriend. Maybe kiss. Married.
Girlfriend.
Waiting for him. Nice kiss. Sort of a traditional thing for the winner. But a lot of times in COVID, I went back to the previous four tournaments. Justin Thomas, I believe, the only person who's been kissed by his girlfriend slash wife after the 18th green. So very simply, will the player who wins the Honda Classic be kissed by his girlfriend slash wife on the lips? And will it be shown on camera when he finishes his 18th hole? Now, guy could shoot 64 on Sunday, could be five groups from the finish and still win. I will be monitoring this. I always watch the golf on Sunday. This will also pay 2-1 if you say yes. So, because, as I said, last four tournaments.
Right on the 18th green.
No, it can happen. He could be walking to the scorer's tent as long as it's shown.
But it has to be at the end of his round and not at the end of the tournament.
You know, within 5 minutes of the end. No.
It's got to happen.
No, why would you say the winner? Like,
it's got to happen before the end of the
tournament. Anytime on the broadcast that he kisses her, that the winner kisses the wife. So if he's on the driving range waiting for a playoff and it doesn't happen.
He wins.
Or if he's in the clubhouse waiting for other guys to finish.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
On camera, kissing girlfriend on the lips or wife. 2-1 odds if you say yes.
Okay.
Jimmy is going to say no to gold bars.
Wow.
So those are my three bets. Puffy, you're next.
I'm going to go three bets on Missouri.
Three bars on Missouri.
I'm going to go three bars on Buffalo.
Okay.
And I'm going to go three bars on no dice on the kiss.
I love gold.
Wow, I went three against the – okay, no problem. Lester?
I got to stick with my bracket. I'm going to go one bar on Oklahoma. I'm going to take the Sabres for two bars because I think they're due and something's got to give there. And I want to say that I believe in love. Yes, I do. And I want to say the kiss for two gold bars.
Beautiful. Stoff?
All right. For me, I'm going to go with Missouri. They've beaten teams that are a 1, a 2, a 3, and a 5 seed in this tournament. So I do like them in this opening round matchup. I am going to go with Boston for two bars. Sorry, Missouri was two bars. Boston, two bars as well.
I love gold.
And then for the final one, I do think it will happen. I'm somewhat worried one of us might miss it. But we'll see. So I'm
going to miss things.
One bar.
Never miss things.
Let's see.
What if it's shown on SportsCenter later?
No.
Well, As long as it happens in the broadcast, right?
Yeah.
It
happens to be on
the broadcast. How else would they show it on SportsCenter? So.
Well, SportsCenter sometimes could get raw feed that didn't make it on air, but it'll be.
If it's on TV, it works.
No, it's got to be on the broadcast. So I think it's a CBS tournament this weekend, or maybe it's NBC, but either way, it's got to be on the broadcast before they go off the air.
No, but say, Jimmy, say you miss it, and then I see it on SportsCenter.
Fine.
You got to let's try to avoid some controversy this week.
There's no chance of that. This is going to be the worst one yet.
No, because If it, then we have to watch SportsCenter too, and maybe it's not on SportsCenter, but it's
hey, on I love Sports watching SportsCenter.
Yeah, but well, Jimmy,
we should. You telling me we should drive the traffic?
So it's like if it's basically come down to if you don't happen to catch it, you.
It's very simple. I will record the event. It I has will to be on the broadcast as soon as they sign off and go to 60 Minutes or whatever the hell channel it is.
To Puffy's point, Jimmy did bet no.
Yeah,
it's in his best interest to not see it.
I will not cheat you. I buried the bunny. I do not lie. I will not
Jimmy's
cheat you.
A web of lies, Jimmy. It's a web of lies.
Bunny's at the dump. And they're making
up. Speaking of which, perfect segue to just before we go, a 1 minute what you watching.
What you watching? Just between you and me, what you streaming on your TV? Let me see. What you watching? Action, drama, comedy, what you streaming on your TV?
The most messed up thing I've seen in a good long time. You guys have Amazon Prime?
Yes.
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 Stars, you can get a free 1 month subscription. Part of it, it's a part of Amazon Prime. That's Prime. The Act. This is the story. I don't know what to do without giving it away. I can't spoiler this. Let me just say, it's a story of this mom and her
daughter,
severely disabled, not really. That's not really a giveaway because you find out right away. Daughter who pulled on one of the great scams in America, and it ends in a twisted web of lies and murder and. And it's a drama. So actors portraying the roles. Patricia Arquette is the mom, who's awesome. Like her career, if you haven't seen Escape from Dannemora, she was unbelievable in it. Unbelievable in this. As is the girl whose name is escaping me, who plays the little girl. But it's messed up. Okay, and it's all true life.
It is.
As in, I did a deep dive afterwards, like going to see. HBO also did a documentary on this case.
And I was going to say there is a documentary on it. Yes.
It's unbelievably, like all the stuff that you see happen, obviously conversations fictionalized, some events fictionalized, but it essentially happened exactly this way and it's deeply messed up. But I would highly recommend it. It'll win all sorts of awards for acting. I guarantee it. The Act, I believe 10 parts. Brooksy and I did a hardcore binge over about 2 days on The Act.
Wow.
This weekend. Mm. So I recommend it. I will not make it your homework, but if you get to it when you can. What an episode this was. Maybe one of our all-time best. And
I think this will go for like 1.7 million. Option.
Yeah, no, it's at $320,000.
Ho.
Ho. Yeah, Ho has just been outbid.
He's good for it too.
Who's up now? Who's got it? Mark Cuban is actually, he's got the highest bid.
Wow.
Right now. I see Scott Speedman getting in there as well.
Oh, also Bump. Bump just put in a bid. It was his only way to get back in. He's at 380 grand.
Bump. Hey, that's
we got to get Bump back on.
We got to get Bump. He's on his way. Well, maybe I'm going to get Bump.
The Masters episode.
Don't forget to fill out your brackets. Don't forget to support our friends at betsafe.net. Don't forget to bid on this episode. Have an awesome week and good luck. And we'll see you next week on the Rubber Boots Pod. Oh, wait a second. You know what? We'll see you Thursday because I'm coming on. I'm coming on live. I'm going to get on. It's going to work for me. Man, I got some bad bags under my eyes today. I'm going to be on. I'm going to be live. This is a big promo. So, I mean, that's value added because no one's going to sign on just to talk to you chumps.
What is more likely?
Hold on 1 second.
Buster's face is just so used to it, it doesn't even change.
You realize, Jimmy, that this promo will run at the end of the episode on Thursday night.
Yeah. Yeah.
When you've already not shown up.
Okay.
That will be the best part.
I'll tweet it out, and then I'm going to sell the tweet.
What's more likely? Nice. Did That's Jimmy bury the bunny or will he show up on Thursday?
Thursday at 6. Hey, Brooksy!
Brooksy!
It's my week off. It's my March break. I am on vacation. It's just a vacation from home.
Showed up.
So this is my only work I'm doing this week.
Oh, wow.
I thought Brooksy was home, so maybe somebody just came in and stole the dog. Like a whirlpool Brooksy guy. Gotta go.
It's getting kind of heavy.
Hey, how are you? I got a question that I really want to ask you. Wait, don't hang up. I need to know, so I'm going to try and push my luck. Are you wearing your rubber boots tonight? Are they purple, yellow, green, or black, or white? Are you wearing your rubber boots tonight? Do you like the dunk tank at the fair?
Are you wearing your rubber boots tonight?